Okay, students. So now let us go for 5-mark important problems on 3-dimensional geometry. Clear? So in the previous class, we have done 5-mark important problems on differentiation, 4-mark problems on continuity. So now we shall move for 5-mark problems on 3-dimensional geometry. So that is your important theorems. Clear? So there are some theorems in your 3-dimensional geometry which are going to be very important for your exams, as well as it is a very important topic to solve the problems on 3-dimensional geometry. So for that reason, we shall look at the problems, we shall look at the theorems of 3-dimensional geometry. Okay, so before going to 3-dimensional geometry, you must know what is vector, what is the definition of vector, what are the examples of vector, and what is scalar, what is the difference between vector and scalar. Clear? Okay, so now, as you all studied in your previous classes, that is 11th standard, that is, vector is an physical quantity which has both magnitude and direction. Clear? Vector is a physical quantity which has both magnitude and direction. On the same way, what is scalar? Scalar is again a physical quantity which has only magnitude. Clear? So that means in scalar there is no direction, but in vector there is both magnitude and direction. Clear? So for that reason, let us see the examples of scalar and vector. Let us see the examples of scalar and vector. See, for scalar, I can write length. That is length. Next, I can write mass. I can write time, temperature, and fifth one, length. So in this video, you can see by side here there are more than 5 number of examples for scalar, so that you can remember at least 5 or 6 of them. So you can see there are so many number of examples by side here. On the same way, let us go for vector. That is, first one, displacement, second one, acceleration, third one, velocity, fourth one, weight, and fifth one, we can write momentum. Clear? Again, there are so many number of examples for velocity also. You can see here by side, so that there are so many number of examples. Just I have written 5 for the explanation, and there are so many number of examples. You can see by side here, I have made a snap of examples of scalar and velocities, so you can go through all those terms. So you must remember that vector means it is a physical quantity which has both magnitude and direction. Scalar means it is again a physical quantity which has only magnitude but no direction. Clear, students? So as you all see here, scalar examples are length, mass, time, temperature, and length. Vector examples are displacement, acceleration, velocity, momentum, and weight. Clear? So I have just written 5 examples of each, but by side you can see there are so many number of examples. and you can make a note of those examples. Clear? Okay. So by seeing these examples, now let us go for the representation of vector. Clear? So how to represent any vector? For example, if I want to represent of point, if I want to represent a point in space with vector form, because representation of a point in space is very important for our three-dimensional geometry. In your three-dimensional geometry particular theorems, we are going to use the representation of point in a space, line in a space, plane passing through intersection of two planes. So that kind of things we are going to use. So for that reason, so let us know how to represent the point in space. Okay, so let us consider that P is a point in space. Now I want to represent this point P. Let us take the three axes x, y and z, x, y and z, because the point is in space. So that if the point is in space, using that point in space, I has to represent that particular point with respect to origin of your space, with respect to origin of your space by taking x, y and z. What we do, we draw a line from O to P. Clear students? We draw a line from O to P. That means whenever we are representing a point in space, we just represent it by joining that point to the origin, so that from origin to this point will be the direction. So here we write it as vector OP. Clear? And we call it as position vector. Position vector of point P. Position vector of point P. Please always remember, vector OP means position vector of point P. Are you clear? These all terms I am going to use in your theorems of three-dimensional geometry. That's why I am explaining. So please don't skip this all terms. Clear? So here OP means position vector of point P, and generally we write vector OP as equal to vector R. In all theorems we use vector OP as vector R in vector form. This is your vector form. Clear? Next, vector R can be written as xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap in, so this in Cartesian form. Clear students? So this is written as in Cartesian form. So this all terms you must know before going to the theorem. Clear? Vector OP means position vector of point P. It is given by vector R, and in the Cartesian form it is written by xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap, where x is x coordinate, y is y coordinate, z is z coordinate, and these terms are also called as direction ratios. If I give x as a, y as b, z as c in vector form. Clear students? Okay. So now OP is position vector of point P, and it is represented by R. It is written as xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap in Cartesian form. Now I am not explaining theorem. I am explaining the things which we need for theorem. Clear? Because whenever we are writing the theorem, whenever I write vector OP, you must know it is position vector of point P, and it should be written as vector R in vector form, and it should be written as xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap in Cartesian form. If you all know these terms, then the theorems will be just of a few minutes, that's all. It's not necessary to by heart, or it's not necessary to write it more and more and more times. You can see that and just you go on writing, that's all. Clear? So that simple are going to be the theorems if you know all these terms. Clear, students? Okay. So now I will take one more point A. Okay, students. Now I will take one more point A. I will join O to A. See, I am joining O A vector. Clear, students? If OP vector is position vector of point P, then OA vector is going to be equal to what? This is position vector of which point? Position vector of, you can say, of which point? Position vector of point A. As you all know, position vector of point A is vector OA. Clear? Now, vector OA will be written as vector A, because this was the point. So using this point, we have written position vector of point A. For that reason, I write it as small letter A with arrow on its head, because vector A should be represented. Clear? So position vector of OA is represented as vector A in vector form. Please remember, this is vector form. Clear? Here, point P was general. Are you getting my point? Point P was general point, or you can say it as arbitrary point. Are you getting my point? Point P is arbitrary. Point A is given. Clear? That is also very important. Here P is arbitrary. Clear? P is arbitrary, and A is given. Clear? So this is what the difference between point P and point A, because you must know how the arbitrary point will be represented and how the given point will be represented, because given means you will be knowing only the values of x, y, z. But in arbitrary, you are not going to know the values of x, y, z. So that's why we write it as x, y, xi cap plus yj cap plus z, k cap. On the same way, now let us write vector OA as x1 I cap plus y1 j cap plus z1 k cap. This is Cartesian form. Cartesian form of your point A. Clear? So vector OA is written as small vector A, and in the Cartesian form, it is written as x1 I cap plus y1 j cap plus z1 k cap. So now we are studying how to represent the points in space of arbitrary and of given. Are you getting my point? These are all things of your basics. These basics you must know. If you know these basics, then it is going to be very useful for your theorems. Are you getting my point? Without these basics representations, you can't do anything in your three-dimensional geometry theorems. Please make sure that you will be perfect with all these terms before going to the theorems of three-dimensional geometry, because in the theorems of three-dimensional geometry, we study the line, the plane, and the distance of two points, the distance of two lines. Clear? So these all terms you are going to be studied in three-dimensional geometry. For that reason, you must know how to represent a point, a line, a vector, a Cartesian form of a given point, a Cartesian form of an arbitrary point. Those all terms you must know. Here you know point P is arbitrary, it is represented as vector R. Here you know point A is given, it is represented as vector A in vector form. In Cartesian form, arbitrary is represented as xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap. But in the given form, it is written as x1i cap plus y1j cap plus z1k cap. These basics you must know. Okay. So now, see here, if I join and if I write AP vector, clear? See my direction, it is A to P. Are you getting my point? This is AP vector, because initial point is A, final point is B, so direction is from A to P. Now it can be called as AP vector. If you change the direction, it can be called as vector PA. Are you getting my point? But let us take AP vector. See, A to P, that's why it is called as vector AP. Are you getting my point? It is called as vector AP. Are you getting my point? See, here point P called as position vector of point P, point A called as position vector of point A, OP is called as position vector of point P, OA is called as position vector of point A. Now AP vector is given as vector AP. That means if you want to find vector AP, first you must know what is initial point of vector and what is final point of vector. Are you getting my point? If you know that two terms, that means what is initial point and what is terminal point or final point, then by using those two terms we can find a vector. See, so now we know point P, we know point A, where point P is arbitrary, where point A is given point. These two points I am using to draw vector AP. Here vector A is given point, vector P is arbitrary point, and we consider A as initial, P as terminal to draw this vector AP. Are you clear? So if I write vector AP, now the important thing is how to find vector AP, because here we have just written the representation of vector AP. Clear? Here we have just written the representation of vector AP. Now we have to give a formula to find vector AP. For that formula, students, I make you one point to remember, that is the distance between two points. Clear? In your first year syllabus or 11th standard syllabus, you always used to calculate distance between two points with what? Square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square plus z2 minus z1 whole square. That you must remember, because here you have two points. Now you want to find vector AP. That is nothing but distance between A and P. Are you getting my point? Vector AP means it is nothing but you have to calculate distance between A to P. That will be the magnitude of vector AP. Are you getting my point? What is vector AP? This is nothing but the length of vector AP. Direction, as you all know, from A to P. Clear? Okay. So as you all recall, the difference between two points, sorry, the length between two points, clear? If you remember that, see, in the vector form, if I want to write vector AP, I will write it as vector OP minus vector OA. Please remember, vector AP is written as vector OP minus vector OA. This is from your triangular addition of vectors, but don't worry about triangular addition of vectors. You just remember the formula, that is vector AP equal to vector OP minus vector OA. We shall read more and more about triangular addition, rectangular addition, parallelogram addition in some other day, but here we are concentrating on theorems of three-dimensional geometry. So let us just focus on what we need for the theorems. Clear? Because if we go on discussing triangular addition, rectangular addition, or a parallelogram addition, hexagonal addition, they are going to be a very lengthy process. But don't let us don't waste the time in that. Directly you must know that vector AP is equal to vector OP minus vector OA. See, here if you don't remember these terms, then it is very tough thing. So for that reason, if you want to write vector AP, you must start with P. Please remember, you must start with P and you must end with A. That means vector OP minus vector OA, position vector of point P minus position vector of point A. Are you getting my point? Clear? Position vector of point P minus position vector of point A. What is vector AP? Position vector of point P minus position vector of point A. See, position vector of P minus position vector of A. Clear? You must remember this formula. Vector AP means position vector of point P minus position vector of point A. Generally, now you can say that what is vector AB? Vector OB minus vector OA. Examples I am telling. Clear? Examples, vector AB can be written as vector OB minus vector A. Same again, see. How can you write vector CD? Clear? Last point D, so that's why vector OD minus vector OA. Are you getting my point? How can you write vector EF? What is last point? F. That is written as vector OF minus vector OE. These all are just examples. Clear? Then whenever you are writing any vector, what will be the formula for that vector? You have to remember. Clear? So if I write vector AP, OP minus OA. If I write AB, OB minus OA. If I write CD, OD minus OA. If I write EF, OF minus OE. Clear? So like that you are finding the vectors. Clear? So now using these two points, what is position vector of point P? Xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap in Cartesian form. In vector form, vector R. That means it will be vector R minus, see here, vector A. Are you getting my point? These all terms I am going to use in your theorems. Clear? OP is written as vector R. OA is written as vector A. Are you getting my point? OP is written as vector R. OA is written as vector A. This is the vector form of your vector AP. Are you getting my point? Vector AP is written as OP minus OA. As we all know, OP is position vector of point P. OA is position vector of point A. That is nothing but vector R minus vector A. If these all terms are well known to you, then the theorems are going to be very, very simple. Are you getting my point? So for that reason, please remember, vector form of vector AP is what? Vector R minus vector A. Why I am explaining all these terms in detail means, these all terms will help you like very thing, because you don't know what will be the help of all these terms while solving the theorems. If you perfect with this, the theorems will be just of your left hand things. Clear? So for that reason, just you go on solving by your left hand, not using right hand. Clear? That simple the theorems are going to be. So for that reason, you don't miss the basics of theorems and the representation of vectors in space. Clear? Okay. Now, R in Cartesian form, how you are going to write? See, xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap. A, how you are going to write in Cartesian form? X1i cap plus y1j cap plus z1k cap. Clear? So now, you represent this in Cartesian form. Vector R minus vector A is in vector form. You represent this term in Cartesian form. How you are going to represent? See, R minus A. That means R minus A. So what we are going to have? X minus X1, Y minus Y1, Z minus Z1. So that is vector R minus vector A equal to, you are going to have X minus X1 I cap plus Y minus Y1 J cap plus Z minus Z1 K cap. Clear students? Okay. So these all terms are very very useful. As I said, if you want to find vector AP, you must know distance between two points for formula. Because see here, X minus X1, Y minus Y1, Z minus Z1, they are called as direction ratios. That we shall study in detail, no problem. But here you must remember that vector AP in Cartesian form, X minus X1 I cap plus Y minus Y1 J cap plus Z minus Z1 K cap. In vector form, vector R minus vector A. See, this is Cartesian. Clear? And here this is vector. This is vector form and this is Cartesian form. Okay, students? So, this all terms you have to remember. Clear? If you remember these terms, then it is going to be very very useful. Otherwise, it is going to be very tough. So, first point, position vector of point P. Second point, position vector of point A. OP in vector form, OP in Cartesian form. Next, the representation of vector AP, that is vector OP minus vector OA, that is the formula of vector AP. How you are going to write it in vector form, that is vector R minus vector A. How you are going to write it in Cartesian form, that is X minus X1 I cap plus Y minus Y1 J cap plus Z minus Z1 K cap. These all terms you must be perfect. If you skip this video, you are not going to get anything. Please write it in your books that if you skip this video or if you skip these terms, it is going to be a very tough thing to solve for you the theorems of three-dimensional geometry. Without knowing this, you can't do anything in three-dimensional geometry. Clear? So make sure that these all terms are perfect before going to the theorems. Clear? So now I will start my theorems one by one. There are 6 to 7 theorems. So let us see those theorems which are going to be very very useful for you.